Ruby. Today I will teach you how to make a Kakamora paper plate from Moana movie.
My materials that I'm going to use are red marker, green, brown, and black. Since I don't have any paint, so I'm going to use this marker. And I need a glue to stick on it. I need white, green, yellow, and brown. And remember, if you use scissors, you have to ask for permission for your parents, okay?
This is the finishing of Pokemon Pirate and Moana.
Hi guys, for this part I'll teach you how to make a seashell picture frame, but make sure that you have an adult with you because we will be cutting some papers.
First, prepare all the materials, which are as follows. Use the craft sticks to make the frame. Paste all of it together, then leave it to dry. Mine, I chose a blue one and made it square shaped. Set aside the craft sticks, then draw some seashells using a pencil. After which, trace the seashells using a pen or a marker so that it would be easier to color. Then, color all of the ones you drew. For my picture frame, I drew 9 seashells, but it's up to you guys how many seashells you want to make. Once you're done coloring all the seashells, cut each piece. This one's optional. You can paste it on a colored paper to make it more vibrant. Then cut all of it again, okay? After cutting all the seashells, paste all of it around the craft sticks. Lastly, put your chosen picture under it. Before displaying your picture frame, make sure you clean up first, okay?
Hi guys, Mr. Eric here. So for this week's project, I'm actually super excited about because we get to work on an art project based on one of my favorite movies of all time. I'm actually super excited they chose this for us. And I bet you guys can't guess what it is, because there are no obvious clues laying around. Yeah, you guessed it, it's Moana. And in keeping with the theme of Moana, guys, I've decided that our art project for this week is Footprints in the Sand. I'll get into how to do it in just a bit. Okay, guys, so for Footprints in the Sand, you're going to need the following things. And remember guys, because this involves paint, make sure you ask your parents for permission first. Oh, and clean up.
Phenomenon, the tide, the grass, the ground. Oh, that was me, I was messing around. I killed a snake, I buried its guts, sprouted a tree, now you got coconuts. What's the lesson? What is the takeaway? Don't mess with Maui when he's on a breakaway. And the tapestry here in my skin is a map of the victories I win. Look where I've been, I make everything happen. Look at that mean mini Maui, just tickety tap, and singing and scratching, flipping and snapping. People are clapping, hearing me rap, and bring the chorus back.
Hi, this is Miss Nilda from Emory. Today, I'm going to teach you how to make a torch. A torch is a source of light used by the early people.
I wish.
The materials needed are different colors of construction papers, pair of scissors, the tape, the cardboard tube, and the glue. Cut the orange construction paper like this. Cover the cardboard tube with a brown construction paper. We're now going to put the planes inside the cardboard tube with the glue. Here now is our finished torch. Be sure to ask the help of an adult in doing the torch. Bye kids, I hope you can make your own torch. Everything is by design.
Hi Emory students, my name is Miss Mori, and today we want to make an easy Moana nature grass hat for kids. So stay tuned. We'll need to cut 5 to 6 different colors of flowers. Remember, whenever you're using the scissors, you need a parent supervision. Whenever you're done cutting, you will have something like this, 5 to 6 flowers. So next, you're gonna need green paper and fold it in half and then cut it. And now, cut the paper to make it look like grass. So now that you have it like this, you need to glue or tape the flowers. So here you have it. Whenever you're done, clean up the table, be safe, be good, and wash your hands all the time. Okay? See you next time. Bye.
Hi, this is Miss Laura from Emory School. Today I'm gonna teach you how to do a Moana bracelet, and I'm gonna give you the material that we're gonna use to do it. Ruler, then thread, it can be wire, scissors, pins, and that's it. Now I'm gonna tell you how to do it. We're gonna start. Okay, we're gonna cut. Remember adult supervision when you are using scissors. With the side for the ruler. I'm gonna start putting.
You can put the beads in the order that you want until you finish your bracelet.
Remember supervision when you are carrying. That's it. Look. Ta-da! Moana bracelet. I miss you.
Don't forget to clean up after you finish.
I hope I see you soon.
Hi guys, this is Mr. Josh here from Emory Elementary. Today, I want to share with you guys a little project I made called the Mini Tiki, inspired by the movie Moana. So before I get into the supplies, like I always say guys, please make sure your parents are supervising at all times. Alright, so let's begin. First things first, you'll need a pencil, some scissors, glue sticks, colored pencils, as well as construction paper of any color you would like. And then lastly, you can either use a toilet paper roll or a paper towel roll. You can see from mine I made right here, I just use a little bit. So, what you do with your pencil first, you grab this, and then you're gonna grab your toilet paper roll and then draw your face. Now you can either copy the one I made right here, or you can use some faces that you see online from other techniques as well, or just make any other type of face too. You're draw that, make sure your facial features like the eyes, mouth, and nose are big enough, and then you can also add extra facial features like I did like mine with little right here, and then you grab your colored pencils, and then color it any color you like, and do any design or pattern, just be creative with it, have a good time with it. And then when you're done with that, guys, you're gonna go grab your pencil again, you're gonna draw a little headpiece on your construction paper, any design you like, and then grab your scissors, and then you're gonna cut it out. Just make sure the piece is big enough so it can fit around the head here. For mine, I made a crown. It's really neat. And then there you go. You have a little mini tiki. So, other than that though, guys, it's a really easy project. Just make sure to clean up after yourselves and have fun with it, okay?
My name is Miss Martha. How are you guys doing today? I hope everyone's doing well. I miss you guys so much. I want to show you a quick art activity you could do at home, and you will know where I got this idea from. It's a famous Disney movie, and you will know at the end, I promise. Let's get started. You need 2 pipe cleaners, 4 beads, and 1 piece of clay. You will know why I chose this color at the end. But as you can see, I'm making a necklace. First, I'm gonna twist my clay so I get it this big, and then we're gonna twist it all the way around to look like a little snail. It's ready to go, and then we're gonna put 1 pipe cleaner on one side, the second one as well, and then you're gonna put the other 2 on the left side of the pipe cleaner. You can make the necklace as long as you want or as big as you want. And then right here, we're just gonna attach it. And remember, guys, if you need help, ask an adult, mommy, daddy, sister, brother, okay? And don't forget to clean up your mess. And this is it. Your Moana necklace. I hope you enjoy, guys. Bye.
Hi, my name is Miss Jasmine, and today I'm going to show you guys how to make tomatoa from Moana. But before we begin, make sure you get parental supervision, or you can get help from an older sibling, and you have to make sure to clean up after yourself. Did your granny say, listen to your heart? Be who you are. First, you take your plate or your circular thing, and you're going to trace it onto the yellow paper, and then you're going to start cutting the circle. Okay, so once you've cut out your circle, you're going to take the blue construction paper and you're going to draw out the outlines for the crown. And once you're done drawing the outline, you're going to cut each piece. After you cut all your pieces, you can take a white piece of paper and draw little ovals on them for the eyes. Okay, so once you've cut out the little eyes,
little Maui's having trouble with his look. You little Sammy Demi mini god. Ouch, what a terrible performance. Get the hook, get it? You don't swing it like you used to, man. Yet I have to give you credit for my start and your tattoos on the outside.
Okay, now we're gonna start decorating the shelf. You can take any colored construction papers and you can draw shapes on them and cut them up. You're going to paste these all over on the shell wherever you want. When you're done pasting the little shapes onto the circle, you can take some markers and draw little squiggly lines or swirls onto the shell. Once you're done decorating the shell, you can then take the arms, the legs, and the face of the crab paste it onto the outer parts of the shell. Okay, once you're done pasting all his limbs and his face onto the shell, then you're finished.
Hello, I'm Risa and this is Miss Sabrina. Today's video, I will show you how to create Moana's boat. The materials you will need will be
Crayolas, cardboard, scissors, construction paper, pipe cleaners, Play-Doh, glue, tape, and color.
So this is the board we're gonna make, and don't forget to have parents and provisions. First, you will get a cardboard, you will cut it as a square. Then we're gonna get the brush, and we're gonna paint it color blue, so it could be the ocean.
Sometimes the world seems against you. The journey may
lead you assault. I'll just let it dry for like 5 minutes. So next day you will get a brown marker, brown construction papers, and scissors.
Drop a diamond.
Then you will cut the four corners.
Will guide you. And nothing on earth can silence quiet voice still inside you.
Then you will fold the four corners. The next day you will need to glue your four corners.
Moana, listen. Do you know who you are?
Then you will cut your symbol. So the next thing we will do, we'll get construction paper, dark and light blue. So we'll just get little pieces and crumble them together. We'll have them like this so the water could be dimensional. To do your flag, you will need Play-Doh and some pipe cleaners. They are brown because I painted them with water paint. So now you will stick your pipe cleaner.
Found their way across the world.
And now, they call here's the result. The symbol you will play.
I've delivered us to where we are.
And there you have it. I have journeyed far. And remember, guys, don't forget to clean up your
I am everything I've learned and more. Still, it calls.